गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे टॉपिक इज हाउ टू प्रिपेयर एंड क्रैक ड्यू एलएलबी। बिफोर मूविंग अहेड आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ इन द शॉर्ट। आई एम बीरेंद्र मिश्रा, प्रैक्टिसिंग एडवोकेट एट दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट्स ऑफ दिल्ली, आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग लॉ फ्रॉम कैंपस लॉ सेंटर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली इन द ईयर 2019। टुडे आई विल स्टिक माई सेल्फ टू द टॉपिक दैट इज how to crack DU LLB and what should be the strategy to follow in order to get your slot in the campus law center. Law Center 1 and Law Center 2. Basically, there are the three centers at the Delhi University. Campus Law Center, Law Center 1 and Law Center 2. And it depends upon your ranks in the entrance examinations. So before moving ahead, why you should go for the DU LLB, let's focus ki why law, why you should move for the law. क्योंकि आप अगर DU LLB करना चाहते हो, कुछ भी चीज करना चाहते हो, that is your objective, your motto should be very clear. कि why you want to go for the law. What you will get after doing from whether from DU LLB for anything, what the advantage you will get if you do from the DU LLB. So if you come across the DU LLB, then the one thing which you can say is the most important, that is the exposure. If you do from the DU LLB, then you have a DU LLB have a great alumni base. Whether you say in terms of the judiciary, then you will find that in at the Delhi High Court itself, out of 35, 60-70% judges are from the law faculty itself. If you say about the lawyers, then in terms of the lawyers also, you will find that eminent lawyers, maximum eminent lawyers are from the law faculty. Namely, you can say even Arun Jaitley Sahab is from the Campus Law Center, Mr. Kapil Sibal from the Campus Law Center, Meera Kumari from the Campus Law Center. And so a lot of people, it's not about the numbers, there are in a lot of numbers who are from the law faculty who have clear there and doing very good. So now let's move to the topic. What is the syllabus? So syllabus is, earlier before it was of 175 questions, sorry, consist of questions containing from polity, legal section, reasoning, maths, English, GK and current affairs. But now the questions come is 100 question, total 100 questions come carrying 4 marks each, and then as well as the negative marks is concerned, 1/4 is the negative marks. So first let's move to the polity. For polity I will refer Lakshmikant and P.N. Bakshi. You can take any one of it. Either you read Lakshmikant or P.N. Bakshi, both are equally very good. And polity contains 20-30% of total questions. So you should have a very good command on the polity. Second, legal, then you should have a knowledge of legal maxims like ubi jus ibi remedium, quantum meriit. So there are a lot. So it's not good platform right now to enumerate all. Just go through the legal maxim. You can find it on the net also, or you can find through the guides available also. And the next is where from you will get the knowledge of the legal questions. For that, you as far as the consti is concerned, you can refer Consti Bare Act also. Otherwise, if you will buy the guide, that is the guide of universal you can take or single you can take. In both are equally good, so you can pick anyone and just go through that. A lot of legal maxim is given and some short summaries about criminal law, constitutional law, tort is also given. And there is no limitation. If you want to extend your knowledge and if you want to be the top rankers, then there is no limit at all. You can read it from the acts itself, from Bare Acts, from books, or from the sources available on the internet. Now let's move to reasoning maths section. For reasoning maths, I will say R.S. Agrawal is good. R.S. Agrawal, you can go through the R.S. Agrawal, and level of reasoning and maths is not very difficult. You can say it's average. 10th standard. And as per as now let's move to the current affairs and GK part. For GK, static GK is concerned, you can refer Lucent. As well as the current affairs is concerned, then you should have the knowledge of 1 year of current affairs. And for this, you can read PD, Pratyogita Darpan. You can also read Ghatna Chakra. Or you can read it from anywhere else. But 1 year of current affairs, you can also refer Drishti, current affairs and all. So I think we are done with polity, we are done with legal, we are done with reasoning maths. GK, okay. And for quick revision, I will say that refer to the guide, that is of the single or universal. So it's all about this. But now I will extend my discussion further towards subtopics. Suppose you are reading the current affairs, then what you should read. In current affairs, mostly the questions are related to the legal current affairs. Legal current affairs, it means related to the appointment, like who is the chairman of the NHRC, women commission ke head kaun hai, minority commissions ke head kaun hai, is tarah ke questions aate hain. To jo bhi legal appointment hote hain, ye sare aapke dimag mein hone chahiye. Ek saal, pichle ek saal mein sports se related questions aapke dimag mein hone chahiye. Ya koi bhi jo naye acts aaye, jaise bhi CA pe koi baat chal rahi hai, farmers act pe baat chal rahi hai, koi bhi recent development jo aaya, amendment jo aaye, ye sari cheeze aapke dimag mein होनी चाहिए. कि अगर आप लॉ एंट्रेंस की प्रिपरेशन करने जा रहे हो तो ये आपको पता होना चाहिए कि अभी रिसेंट 1 ईयर्स में लॉ में क्या डेवलपमेंट्स हो रहे हैं. इसके बाद आते हैं स्टैटिक जीके में. तो स्टैटिक जीके में आपको मैंने पहले बता रखा है कि आप लुसेंट पढ़िए. अब पॉलिटी में जब हम लोग आते हैं तो पॉलिटी में कौन सा इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है. तो पॉलिटी में आप देखें तो एज सच इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक आपको तो पढ़ना सब चाहिए. पॉलिटी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्योंकि यही एक टॉपिक है, यही एक सेक्शन है जहां से आपको मैक्स लेकर के आना है. आपको इसमें 95% स्कोर करना है. तो इसके लिए मैं कुछ सब टॉपिक्स डिस्कस करता हूं आपसे. जैसे आप इसमें अमेंडमेंट पढ़ सकते हैं, अमेंडमेंट का टॉपिक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. फिर जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट जुडिशियरी वाली जो टॉपिक है पॉलिटी कॉन्स्टी में, वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. प्रेसिडेंट कैसे बनते हैं, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट कैसे बनते हैं, सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजेज का क्वालिफिकेशन क्या होता है, हाई कोर्ट जजेज का क्वालिफिकेशन क्या होता है, ये सारे बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. इसके बाद बिल्स वगैरह भी आप थोड़ा देख लेंगे कि मनी बिल्स हो गए, पार्लियामेंट के बारे में, ये सारी चीजें इंपॉर्टेंट है. फिर शेड्यूल्स, कितने शेड्यूल्स होते हैं, सारे शेड्यूल्स में क्या दे रखा है, ये सारी चीजें भी इंपॉर्टेंट है. बट यू हैव टू नॉट गो थ्रू द इम्पॉर्टेंट राइट नाउ बिकॉज आई थिंक सफिशियंट टाइम इज देयर. 6 to 7 months वुड बी देयर. जनरली इट इज एग्जामिनेशन इज हेल्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ जून और मे. जून आई अपियर इन 2016 इन द मंथ ऑफ जून. इट वॉज 19th June इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली. सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट दिस. लेट मी चेक इफ आई हैव मिस्ड एनीथिंग. या नाउ आफ्टर ऑल दिस I will conclude by saying that what is the things you can say, what is the USP of getting into the law faculty. I would like to name some persons which will keep you motivated to be the part of the law faculty. Right now 28 judges or 27 judges of the High Court are from the of Delhi High Court are from law faculty itself. Even at our apex court, Supreme Court, out of 34, around 10 to 12 judges are from the campus law center and some LC1 and LC2, that is from the law faculty. If you talk about the corporates, if you talk about the eminent lawyers, if you talk about the politicians, all are from the law background. So, and one more thing, if you come here, it's not about that you are getting the good classes. And one thing I missed, that is the pattern of a study. Here you read law, you study law, not by sections only. The method is case law studies. So suppose if you are reading FIR, then FIR is not about 154 only. You have to also read the Lalita Kumari judgment. If you are reading about the arrest, then you have to also read the DK Basu. So pattern, a study pattern is very fine. and no doubt legacy of, I think it had started in the year 1924. So even, so wherever you will go, to any office, you will find someone from the campus law center, someone from LC1, someone from LC2, means from the law faculty. So this is the beauty of law center. So I think this is the time to say your goodbye.
60%.
So thank you so much. Wish you all the best. Good luck. Thank you.